गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 7, वेरिएशन। नाउ व्हाट इज वेरिएशन एंड इन दिस व्हाट इज देयर। इन दिस चैप्टर वी लर्न टू थिंग्स, वन इज डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन एंड द इनवर्स वेरिएशन। नाउ व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन एंड इनडायरेक्ट, विल सी इट नाउ। नाउ व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट, डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन नथिंग बट अ डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शन। डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शन व्हाट, सपोज यू टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ टाइम एंड द डिस्टेंस। Suppose the distance traveled by car and the time taken for it. If the time taken for a car in 2 hours, it covers a distance of 90 kilometers. 3 hours, it takes the distance is equal to one. It covered 135 kilometers. 4 hours, 180. 5 hours, 225. What it mean? If I'm seeing this, we can understand that when the number of hours increases, the number of kilometers also increases. This is called direct variation. This there is direct variation between the two quantities, x and y. This statement can be written as x varies y. Direct variation means the formula x varies y. Now when we remove this varies symbol, it becomes here x is equal to ky, where k is constant of variation. Okay, and therefore we can say as x is equal to ky is an equation of direct variation. Now we will take one example here. Compute the following considering the cost of an apple and the number of numbers are in direct variation. What it means that number of apple will consider as x and the cost of an apple is y. When number of apple is 1, the cost is equal to 8 rupees. If the cost of an apple is equal to 56, how many numbers of apples are there? That we have to find out. Now it is direct variation. Direct variation means we have to write a symbol here, x varies y. Therefore x is equal to ky. And previously we have told it, where k is constant. First we have to find the k. Now what is x is equal to 1 and ky is equal to 8. Therefore what we can say is, Therefore, x is equal to ky. So we know x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 8. Therefore, k we have to find out. So what we can say, 1 upon 8 is equal to k. So here we can say, therefore, k is equal to 1 upon 8. Now we have found out the k. Now we have to find this answer. Number of apple. What we can say, we have to use again the same formula. What is x is equal to? X is equal to ky. Now here they are given as the y. So we will get x we don't know. We will keep x as it is. Y we know. K we know. What is k? K is equal to 1 upon 8. Now y is how much? 56. Now here we can say 8 7 is 56. 8 1 is 8. 8 7 is 56. 1 multiplied by 7 is equal to 1 multiplied by 7 is equal to 7. Therefore we can say x is equal to 7. Now what is x? X means what is x? X means the number of apple. That is we can write the answer is 7. Okay, end out here. Understood? You can take the screenshot also. Now we'll take the next example. The second example is, if m varies n, when m is equal to 154 and n is equal to 7, find the value of m when n is 14. Now first what we have to do, first we have to write the first, it is direct variation, we have to write the first symbol here. What is the m varies n? After that what we will write, therefore m is equal to kn, where m k is constant. K is constant. Okay, we can write a k is constant. After that what they are given us here, k is constant. They are given us m is equal to 54. We write here m is equal to 54, n is equal to 7. Now we will use this formula here, m is equal to kn. M is how much? 154 is equal to k, we have to find out, k keep as it is, multiplied by n. N is how much? 7. Now we have to divide this here. 154 divided by 7 is equal to k. If we divide this here, we'll get an answer here. 7 is 7, 7 2 is 14, 1 remaining 7 is 14. Therefore, we can say as k is equal to 22. Now I got the value of k is equal to 22. Now I want to find the when n is 14, the what is m? So what do you write? Again, we use this formula same again. What do you write here? M is equal to kn. I want to find the value of m. Keep as it is. K I know, it is 22. N is how much? 14. Write 14. When you multiply this, therefore m is equal to, when this multiply 22 multiply by 14, we'll get the answer here 308. Therefore we can say, therefore m is equal to 308. This is our answer. Okay, find out. Now second one. Now, second is we learn about the inverse ratio. What is inverse ratio? In a pair of number, if the increase in one number causes a decrease in the other number, means what? One number increases and other number decreases, then it is called as a inverse proportion. In the direct proportion, what happens? One number increases, the other also increases. In this one number increases and the other number decreases. That is called an inverse. For example, we take number of worker taken to do the work. Number of workers. If two workers are there, it takes 36 days to complete the work. If three workers are there, it takes 24 days. If four workers are there, it takes 18 days. And six workers are there, it takes 12 days. Now, in this, we can see from these numbers or two, when the number is increasing, number of workers is increasing, the number of days decreases here. If first is 36, 24, 18, 12. So, what it means that if one thing is increasing, another is decreasing, then we can say that it is inverse variation. It means that the number of days and the number of workers are in the inverse variation. Okay, this is called as an inverse variation. Now, this can the symbol we can say the formula is equal to x varies 1 upon y, therefore x is equal to k upon y. In the direct variation, what we are saying, x is equal to k into y. Here is k upon y. Now, we can take one example where k is constant. Now, we will take the same example here. So, number of workers is equal to 30 and the number of days is equal to 6. We have to find the how many, if the 6 days takes here, how many numbers of workers will be there. Now what we say, x varies 1 upon y, where x is equal to k upon y. Now first we have to find out the k. Now what is k? X is how much here? We'll write here, x is equal to 30 is equal to k upon y. Therefore what you say, therefore y is how much? Y is equal to 6. We can add 6. This will become, if this side will become here, multiply, divide, it become a multiplier. Means what you can say, 30 multiplied by 6 is equal to k. Therefore k is equal to 180. I got the value of k is equal to 180. Now we have to find the number of workers if number of days is 12. So what is there here? X we have to find out here, and Y we know it is 12, and the K we know 180. Now 180. Okay. Now we'll use the same formula here. What we'll say as X is equal to K upon Y. The X we want to find out here. X is a K we know. What is K? K is equal to 180. And what is Y? Y is equal to 12. Okay. Now x is equal to 180 upon 12. Now we can say 12 ones are 12. Then we can say 12 15s are. Therefore we can say x is equal to 15. 15 is the answer. Okay. 15 is the answer. Now what is x? X is a number of workers. So we can write here it is 15. Okay. End out here.